Hello everyone, my name is Sean Lee and I'm an engineer at Agilent Technologies. In today's video, I'm going to share with you how you can test low voltages or low logic level audio ICs with the Agilent U8903A audio analyzer. Here's an overview of today's test setup. We'll be using a digital analog IC evaluation board as our DUT today. And of course, you will need a power supply to power on the DUT, as well as bench DMM, which is used to monitor the power supply to the DUT. And of course, last but not least, you'll need an audio analyzer, which we'll be using the U8903A with digital option. And what you need is to generate a SPDI signal to the DUT, while the DUT output will be routed back to the audio analyzer for analysis. First thing that we need to measure is the minimum working voltage. Now to do this, we will need to use a measurement function called AutoBit, or to be more specific, walking zero. Now this function is designed to monitor the transaction status of each audio bit. So when the IC or DUT handles the transaction correctly, you will see the zero bit rotate or walk along each bit, so hence the name walking zero. If the DUT stops working, the zero bit will stop. Now this is a test often used by R&D engineers to check on the working status of the audio ICs during circuit design. Now let's start the test. We will measure the minimum working voltage using two different settings or scenarios. First, we will be using the input logic level of 3.3 volt, which I already preset earlier. Now, this is a common setting found on most audio analyzers in the market. Next, we gradually lower down the DC power supply voltage. As you can see now, power voltage is at 3.3 volt and my zero bit is rotating or walking. As we gradually lower down the power supply voltage, you might start to see some bit showing zero, which is perfectly fine as long as the zero is still rotating. What we're trying to achieve here is take the measurement when the zero completely stops. So as you can see, at 2.4 volts, the zero completely stopped. So if we take a look at our DMM, it's reading 1.57, so this will be our minimum voltage. For scenario 2, we'll repeat the same test, but only this time we will be using a much lower logic input level of 1.2 volt. Once we set that, go back to the earlier audio bit screen. And again, we gradually lower down the power supply voltage until the zero bit stops. So the zero bit stops completely at 2 volt. And take a look at the reading of a DMM. It's showing a minimum voltage value of 1.14 volt. So the question is, why is the test result different? So which one is the correct measurement? Now this chart shown is drawn based on our test results. It clearly shows that with only changes of the input logic level from 3.3 volt to 1.2 volt, which is to match the DUT's output, the minimum voltages improved from 1.57 volt to 1.14 volt. So let me explain why this happens. First of all, when we set the audio analyzer input logic level to 3.3 volt, which is a fixed setting found on most audio analyzer, the DUT stops working at 1.57 volt. Is this true? The answer is a resounding no. As a matter of fact, the DUT is still working, but the audio analyzer could not interpret the logic correctly with a fixed 3.3 volt logic level. As the DUT voltage gets lower, the DUT's logic level will decrease as well, and if the audio analyzer is not able to reduce or interpret lower logic level, this will cause test errors due to incompatibility. Thus, by lowering the logic level to 1.2 volt to match the DUT's output in scenario 2, we are able to measure the true minimum working voltage. In short, most modern audio ICs are heading towards low logic level design. And if your audio analyzer does not allow you to adjust and measure low logic level, you will not be able to design or evaluate your ICs correctly. So the Agilent U8903A is designed specifically to solve this issue because it has the widest logic level from 1.2 volt to 3.3 volt and allows users to input any value in between. So for more information, please visit www.agilent.com/find/audioanalyzer-demo. Hope that this sharing was useful and thanks for joining me today.